One of the key things about working in museums is you need equipment that has a long life. Its longevity is important to us. One of the problems with the London Transport Museum is we're a museum of transport where nothing moves. And so we deliberately chose to use projection to inject animation into the museum to bring that sparkle, that life, that feeling of movement, even if we couldn't actually move the vehicles themselves. One of the other areas that we specifically chose projection design projectors for was our design gallery. London Transport has a fabulous heritage of design, which is very hard to push into a tiny museum in Covent Garden. And what we've done is we have created a cabinet of curiosities of design over the last 100 years in the gallery and brought it to life with a 7-screen projection across the floor and walls of the gallery. This has really engaged our audience in unexpected ways. During the design process for the galleries, we went through a period of beauty contests where we sampled all the projectors that were available on the market and looked for the projectors that were best suited to each of the designed areas that we had. For this, certainly for the design gallery, the F1 shone out as being the projector we had to use. Its ability to be mounted in different directions, its off-axis projection meant that we could actually squeeze this seamless large screen onto the floor into what is an incredibly complicated ceiling structure, which we couldn't achieve with another projector. I'd compare the projectors that we require to this train that we're sitting in. 1938 it was brought into service, carried on in service to 1984. If we can reach that kind of parallel with our projection equipment, working every day, serving London 7 days a week, that would be perfect for us.